So you've got a 2-year-old you're contending with, and I have my 9-year-old, not even the 7-year-old, Caroline, who is now so afraid of everything that then she'll just try and sleep in, sneak in the bed.
Right.
Then she kicks me all night, so then I end up going to the guest room, and it's very sad.
Aww.
And not getting any sleep.
Now, what are you supposed to do if they're 9? I mean, you can't... What do you do?
I've talked to several people, specialists. You know, we check for monsters under the bed.
Okay.
I don't know. It's really been since we moved into the new house. And it's bigger. Before, they were right...
Right next to you, yeah.
Their door was literally right. So now they're a floor away from me.
Right.
And it's like, oh, my God. She's like, it's all good. So anyway, we'll figure we're not getting a good night's sleep. But so here's the thing, but we still have to be on and perform the next day. So what do we do?
Okay, so this article is perfect for that because it is, if you've had the bad night of sleep, here are some things to make your next day easier, right? Okay, so they say don't hit the snooze button because that actually has the opposite effect that you think it would, because if you fall back to sleep and then you wake yourself up, you'll in turn be groggier.
I did it twice today.
Okay,
I know.
Well,
I try not to.
It's all about keeping the circadian, I thought it was circadian, it's circadian rhythms intact, okay? All right, okay. Now, it also says to open the curtains because natural light actually helps produce cortisol, which is what you need in the morning, and melatonin, and it suppresses serotonin, natural light.
Okay.
So expose yourself to natural light.
I
think that's correct.
Yes.
No. That was a lot of.
You know what?
Okay.
Somebody check all those. Check all the tonins out. Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
No, I believe that.
Yeah. Right.
And we've got the shutters, so the room gets really, really dark.
Sure.
And then once I open them all up, you do
you feel
you,
good.
You
it's
do
an
it,
alert
like
for your
said,
body to be
right
like,
away.
Okay, it's time to start the day.
Right away. Get those shutters open.
Okay. Like the shutters. It feels so like you're in a movie. Open the shutters.
Yes.
Okay. And the birds. Oh, that's Sleeping Beauty. Cinderella.
Yes.
I love that. Okay. Anyway, take a shower. So this is a hot tech tip from Silicon Valley. All the tech people are doing it. They say you take a freezing cold shower in the morning, and that is supposed to alert, get your blood flowing.
That is a no.
To all the limbs, it says.
No,
I was that sounds like private.
My showers are so hot.
Yeah.
Like it's,
well,
I know it's not good for my skin, I know.
Well, somebody, I once commented, this lovely man, he was like a younger man, but I was like, you have amazing skin. He was like, I'm Puerto Rican. I was like, sweet. I was like, what else do you do? And he said, I don't take hot showers. He said, I only take cold showers. And I was like,
okay.
I'm not doing that.
Yeah, you're like, okay, well, I guess I won't have soft, silky skin like you.
Right, I'll just keep using a vino.
Yep, that's right.
Okay, this next one was interesting too. So it says to have 2 food groups for breakfast. So to do a sugar, but a natural sugar like fruit and combine it with protein. However, I'm like, the first sentence was, do not eat cereal and granola. And I was like, that's what I have every single morning because I'm giving my kids cereal or granola and I just eat kind of what they don't eat, you know?
Right.
And they said that
you
crash later.
Yes, absolutely. Well, Jim has been making the egg whites. He's been really good about that, but he's out of town right now. So this morning I was like,
he's
egg, fend for yourself. No, I'm kidding.
Love it.
We did have cereal and I try to put out the fruit.
Right.
But, yeah.
I know it's hard, especially when you're in a hurry. That's really hard. Okay.
I know.
All right, the next one is to time your caffeine fix. So this is interesting with the cortisol. So they say your cortisol levels are highest in the morning, which produces all the things you need to get going for the day, right? Caffeine suppresses cortisol. So if you have your cup of coffee, as soon as you wake up, you're not letting your body do its natural thing. And I was like, oh, man,
I'm doing a lot for the coffee.
I don't even say hi or anything.
No, like straight for the Keurig. Uh-huh. That's what I do.
Yeah.
Put my Paul Newman dark blend in.
Yeah.
Paul Newman blend.
And
no, listen, how about when you put in the wrong Keurig and it's super light? You know what's happened to you.
Right.
Jim goes and gets a big thing at Costco and it's like a blend that's just way too weak.
Okay.
I can always tell when I look at it. I'm like, no, this is not thick.
This isn't good.
Thick and dark.
This isn't like battery acid.
Yep,
that's what
exactly.
We like. Yes.
That's what we like. Okay, Lance, sorry, we're hurrying.
Okay,
the next one is,
this is interesting too. So it says, if you get less than 6 hours of sleep at night, do not work out the next morning because you can actually do more harm to your body than good.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just trying to, I'm just like, if I work out, it's a victory.
Yeah, I'm just, I'm just trying to stay awake.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, those were good. We're going to put them on our Facebook page because it's great information.
It really
all have those days we don't sleep and we need all the help we can get.
We do.
So thank you, Cara. Yeah.